The Occupational Safety and Health Administration says employers can save between $4 and $6 for every dollar they invest in training and prevention. It pays off in lower cost, increased productivity, and safer workers. A look at the latest data on the most cited OSHA standard violations will give you a good idea of where you should be spending your training dollars. By properly training your team to avoid common violations, you can protect your workers and avoid hefty OSHA fines. Let's take a look at OSHA's top 10 most frequently cited violations. Number 10, eye and face protection. According to the CDC, each day roughly 2,000 U.S. workers suffer a job-related eye injury that requires medical treatment. The majority of injuries are caused by small particles or objects that strike or scrape the eye, such as dust, cement chips, metal slivers, nails, or drywall. Chemicals can also cause burns to a worker's eyes or face. Employers should provide appropriate PPE to prevent eye and face injuries. Guards and controls on machines can help prevent particles from shearing off during operation. Welding curtains can prevent arc flashing. And goggles and face shields provide higher impact protection. Eye protection policies should include eye wash stations and training on OSHA's eye and face protection standard. Number 9, machine guarding. Workers face serious hazards when barrier guards, two-hand tripping devices, electronic safety devices, and other methods of machine guarding are not properly employed. Guards should be attached to machines whenever possible. Employers should train workers on OSHA's machinery and machine guarding standard and ensure that guard use does not create its own safety hazards. They should also provide proper equipment for machine guarding and make sure workers know the correct way to attach and detach guards. Number 8, fall protection training requirements. Since falls are the most common source of worksite injuries, it's not surprising that OSHA penalizes businesses that don't comply with OSHA training requirements for fall protection. Employers are required to provide training to any employee who might be exposed to fall hazards on the job. This includes qualified training on procedures to erect, maintain, disassemble, and inspect fall protection systems. Workers should also be trained on the safe operation of personal fall arrest systems, safety nets, warning line systems, control access zones, and guardrails. Number 7, powered industrial trucks. Forklifts, tractors, platform lift trucks, and other types of powered industrial trucks can expose workers to significant safety hazards. One of the leading causes of accidents for powered industrial trucks is striking pedestrians or other workers. Workers who use this equipment should be certified and trained on the OSHA powered industrial truck standard. Employers should provide safety belts on forklifts and require workers to wear them during operation. Loads should be wrapped in plastic shrink wrap to increase stability. Number 6, ladders. More than half of all deaths involving ladders occur in the construction industry, according to the Center for Disease Control and Prevention. Experts point to inexperienced workers or a lack of proper safety training as the main causes of accidents with ladders. Employers should make sure workers are adequately trained on the OSHA ladders standard. Best practices include choosing the right ladder for the job, securing ladders, and placing them in safe positions, and maintaining 3 points of contact with the ladder at all times during use. Number 5, respiratory protection. Another frequently cited violation involves respiratory problems caused by breathing air contaminated with harmful dust, fog, fumes, gas, smoke, sprays, or vapors. When employers fail to practice accepted engineering control measures for safe ventilation or fail to provide appropriate personal protective equipment, they risk receiving an OSHA violation. The OSHA Respiratory Protection Standard includes a list of respirator types and the situations in which they should be used. Employers should ensure they provide adequate PPE, and employees receive proper training on when and how to use it. This includes training on donning and doffing, PPE limitations, and maintenance. Employers should also create a written respiratory protection program and appoint a trained program administrator to oversee the program. Number 4, lockout tagout. The Control of Hazardous Energy Standard applies to situations where starting up equipment could release stored energy and harm workers. Employers should train workers on proper lockout-tagout practices and procedures. Equipment and machinery should be discharged of energy or equipped with a tagout or lockout device whenever stored energy poses a hazard to workers. If equipment is not capable of being locked out, a formal tagout program should be created to protect workers. Once a lockout or tagout device has been put in place, only the employee who applied the device is permitted to remove it. Number 3. Scaffolding. You see them everywhere, from small buildings to massive high-rises. Scaffolding is used for a wide variety of construction, inspection, maintenance, and repair projects. According to OSHA, an estimated 2.3 million construction workers work on scaffolding frequently. With such a large percentage of the workforce working at heights, it's no surprise scaffolding ranks so high on the list. Common causes of scaffolding accidents include plank or flooring collapse, slips and falls, and defective scaffold setup. Employers should inspect scaffolding construction daily and make sure they maintain compliance with OSHA standards. Number 2. Hazard communication. Any company that uses potentially hazardous chemicals must communicate the safety and health risk of those chemicals to employees. You must also provide guidance on what to do in the event of an emergency. OSHA's Hazard Communication Standard covers best practices for keeping workers informed of health and safety risks. All chemicals should be properly labeled with easily readable signs. Employers should maintain accurate records of all hazardous chemicals at the worksite and provide safety data sheets to workers and customers. Number 1. Fall Protection General Requirements. The leading cause of death in the construction industry is falling. OSHA statistics show that falls in construction make up more than one-third of all private sector worker deaths. OSHA requires employers to comply with its fall protection standard. It is the employer's responsibility to set up controls to protect workers from falls associated with overhead platforms, floor holes, and elevated workstations. This involves planning jobs carefully and providing fall protection equipment to workers who are 6 feet or more above lower levels. To prevent falls, your team should regularly inspect ladders, scaffolding, and safety gear, such as personal fall arrest systems and harnesses. You can avoid OSHA violations and injuries with workplace safety training. Training your workforce on safety standards can also protect your business from OSHA fines, which can add up quickly. Employers can be hit with a penalty of up to $13,653 per violation. Developing an ongoing workplace safety training program is the key to preventing avoidable accidents, injuries, illnesses, and deaths. Be sure to click the like and subscribe buttons below, leave a comment if you agree with our list, and visit naspweb.com to learn more about training opportunities provided by NASP.